Hello and welcome back to the course of mechatronics. I'm Izada, and today we are dealing with the point regarding analog to digital converters. So we already gone through a few videos of ADCs. Again, in this video we'll go through types of ADC, out of which the two types: flash ADC, successive approximation ADC, are to be studied. Here again we'll be going through the second type, that is successive approximation analog to digital converter, in this video, as we have already gone through the flash type of ADC in last video. We will be continuing with the successive approximation A to D converter in this video. So let's start with successive approximation ADC. So different elements of successive approximation ADC, as mentioned here, we in circuit we are having a comparator, a digital to analog converter, successive approximation resistor, and control. So these are different elements which we are going to go through while studying this successive approximation resistor, or rather A to D convert. So the block diagram of successive approximation is shown here. In this block diagram, as we can see here, one comparator is used, as we have already gone through. A comparator is present, a D to A converter, that is a digital to analog converter, is required. Then successive approximation resistor is there, and again the control for this control is used to admit the pulses in storage register, and this is a clock pulse given to the successive approximation resistor. Here in this diagram we'll be looking at a 4-bit output. Okay, so this digital output is a 4-bit number. So D1, D2, D3 and D4 are 4 bits, in which D1 is the MSB, that is most significant bit, and D2, D3 and D4. D4 is the least significant bit. So this is 4 bit A to D converter. So again, we know resolution is again dependent on the number of bits we are going to use. So here for simplification we have gone for the 4-bit, as we are going to go through working of this A to D converter while studying. So higher number of bits will again create more complexion for understanding. That's why we are going for the simpler 4-bit A to D converter first. Then we will again go for higher resolution of this successive approximation ADCs. More number of bits can be used. Okay, so here you can see this VA is nothing but applied voltage or analog voltage which we are going to receive from a sensor and which is to be converted to a digital one. So this is, that is again given to the positive terminal of comparator, that is op amp, or rather non-inverting terminal of comparator. And the output is connected to successive approximation resistor. Whatever the value stored in successive approximation resistor is given to D to A converter as well as to the output. Okay, so D to A converter will again convert that digital value to some reference, some voltage. It is mentioned here by VD. So VD is the output of this DAC. Some reference voltage again we are going to provide to this DAC. Again we will go through the complete working of DAC in next lectures. Here we will be concentrating on ADCs. So DAC will give us the output in form of some voltage, say VD, and that is again connected to the negative terminal of comparator, that is inverting terminal of a comparator. So we are having here again two different voltages which will be compared, and accordingly the output of this comparator will trigger the action in the SAR, and again we will get some values present here in this output. So divided to D3, D4, 4 bits. Okay. So this is the working of a successive approximation ADC. We'll be definitely going through an example for the better understanding of the working of this system. Say here I have mentioned the detail in tabulated form. So we are having here digital output of D1, D2, D3, D4. D1 is my most significant bit and D4 is my least significant bit. So basically here D1, D2, D3, D4, 4 bit are the digital output, and the VD is nothing but it is the voltage given by the DAC, which will be again supplied to a comparator. So the value we are going to, how do we get the values, that we are going to go through. For this we need to go for how the successive approximation ADC works. Very first point is, when new conversion starts, SAR sets MSB to 1 and all others to 0. So at very start, when we are going to start the successive approximation ADC, it will firstly store the value of all the bits like this one. So MSB is set to 1 and all other bits are set to 0. So this gives me a binary 4 bit number 1000, which is again equivalent to 8 in decimal. So we know here how, as I am assuming here that all of you know how a binary digit is converted to a decimal digit, or I will just briefly explain here. So whatever the number we are having here in a binary form, which is in ones and zeros, so how to convert it to a decimal point, it is very simple. What we do usually is we multiply these bits with powers of 2 and add them all for getting a decimal number. So by starting from LSB to MSB, so this is the very first number. From this towards the left hand side where we'll be moving. So, and again the power of 2 will be incrementing by 1 at each time. So this number will be multiplied by 2 power 0, so, or 2 raised to 0. So 2 raised to 0 is, we know, 1. So 1 into 0, 0. Then this number will be multiplied by 2 power 1, so it is 2. So 0 into 2, again it is 0. This number will be multiplied by 2 power 2, so it is again 0 into 2 power 2, 2 power 2 is 4, so 0 into 4 is again 0, so 0 plus 0 plus 0, all zeros, so only this is 1, so 1 into 2 power 3, so 2 power 3 is 8, so 1 into 8 is 8, so number, decimal number is 8, so 2 power 0, 2 power 1, 2 power 2 and 2 power 3. Likewise, we are going to multiply these numbers with the power of 2s and add all them. So, we will get a decimal number. So, here it is 1 into 2 power 3. 2 power 3 is 8. So, 1 into 8 is 8. So, we will get decimal value 8. So, that is the output of a D2A converter, which we are going to get here. So, 8 volts will be given to the comparator. Say in this example we are going to take VA as 5.1 volt. Okay, so here it is mentioned our analog voltage which we want to convert will be equal to 5.1 volt. So if we go for the previous slide here, so here at VA we are going to supply 5.1 volt, and at this point right now we are supplying 8 volts. So keep in mind, at positive side VA is there, at negative side VD is there. Okay, so we are supplying VA 5.1 volt, and now right now VD is 8 volt. So at very first M is be set to 1 and all other are 0. So 8 will be given to comparator, and at other terminal VA is 5.1. So when VA is less than VD, set bit is reset to 0. Okay. So set bit is reset to 0. So what happens here is, as we know that here VA is 5.1 volt and VD is 8 volt. So as 5.1 is less than 8, the set bit is reset to 0 and next bit is set to 1. Okay. Likewise, see here, when VA is less than VD, set bit is reset to 0 and next bit is set to 1. So here now MSB is reset and D2 will be set to 1. So likewise, here again this is equivalent to 1 into, you know, 2 power 0, 2 power 1, 2 power 2. So 1 into 2 power 2, it is 4. So we will get now 4 volts as an output of DAC, which is again given to the comparator in previous diagram. Let know. So now we are having VA as 5.1 and VD as 4. So right now this is the case. VA is now greater than VD, as VA is 5.1 and VD is 4. So it is greater than VA is greater than VD. So set next bit to 1. So the bit which is set as 1 will not be changed, but next bit will be converted to 1. Okay. So this will become now. See here, it is 1 into 2 power 2, that is 4, plus 1 into 2 power 1, that is 2. So 4 plus 2, it is 6. So it will be now again converted to 6 volts and it is again given to comparator. So again, comparator will be comparing VA and VD. So again, VA is 5.1, as which is supplied analog voltage, and VD is now 6, which is again greater than VA. So again, one first case, that is VA is less than VD. So what happens? Now we are here. So at this point, this bit is going to get reset to 0 and next bit will be converted to 1. Okay. So when VA is less than VD, set bit is reset to 0 and next bit is set to 1. So this is now set to 1. So here what is going to happen? Again, here it is 2 power 2 into 1, that is 4. And here it is 1 into 2 power 0. 2 power 0 is 1, 1 to 1, 1. So 4 plus 1 is equal to 5. Okay. So we will get now 5 volts, but all the bits are now changed. So the successive approximation ADC will stop here by giving us the value of 5 volts, which is nearer to 5.1 volts. So I think you have got idea here that how it's got converted. Okay. So this is actually for n bit ADC, n clock cycles are required for conversion. So here it is 4 bit ADC. So this is the first cycle, second cycle, third cycle, and in fourth cycle we have got the converted value in digital form. So for n bit ADC, n clock cycles are required for conversion. So for 4 bit ADC, 4 clock cycles are required. In every cycle, one approximation. So it is, that's why it is called as a successive approximation. So in every cycle, we will be going towards the value, analog value, and we will reach. So that's why I told you for 5.1 volt, it is showing 5 volts, as we have taken very basic 4 bit ADC here. So its accuracy will be less. So at higher resolutions, we can, because here for this the resolution is 1 volt, so we cannot go for this point value here. So we need to go for higher number of bits. So we can go for 8 bit, 12 bit, likewise if we increase. But here for explanation, we have taken the simpler one, 4 bit. We can go for 8 bit, 16 bit. Okay, right now systems are running or 64 bit. If it is possible, we can go through such a huge number, so which will be having very, very high resolution and high accuracy. So this is regarding the successive approximation ADC. I think all of you have got idea regarding how the successive approximation ADC works. Okay, so if we need to go for another example, see here, this is 5.1 volt. Okay, that's why we have gone like this. Suppose if it is 9 volts, what will happen? So again, for 4 bit, see, if now I am supplying VA 9.1 volts, okay, exactly, we don't take exact value here like 5 volts because we don't know what is the signal coming from a sensor, which is an analog signal. It won't be exact integer value, it may be varying or it may be a fraction value. So for better understanding, we are taking here some a fraction value. So suppose it is 9.1 volt, what will happen? So if it is 9.1 volt, so at very start of the conversion, MSB will be set to 1 and all other will be 0. So again, we are going to get 8 as the output of DAC, which is again set to comparator. So comparator will be comparing here. Now what will happen here, VI is 9.1 and VD is 8. So this is the case, VI is greater than VD, so it set next bit to 1. So this will be kept 1 as it is and the next bit will be set to 1. So it will become 1100 in the next example. So 1100 will give us actually 8 plus this will be 2 power 0, 2 power 1, 2 power 2. So 2 power 2 is 4. So it will be 2 power 3 is 8. 8 plus 4, this will give me 12. So this will give me 12. So now again this 12 is sent to comparator. So again now 9.1 is less than 12. So what's going to happen? It will reset bit to 0 and set next bit to 1. So here it will become 101 in third cycle. So 101 will give me now 8 plus 2, that is 10. Again it will be VA less than VD. So here 1010 was there, so it will become for last cycle 1001. So 1 here will give me 8 and 1 here will give me 1. So 8 plus 1 will be equal to 9. So in the fourth cycle we will get 9 volt as an output. So likewise, successive approximations will be done, and based on that the output will be generated. So I hope you have understood the successive approximation ADC. Here are the few advantages of successive approximation ADC. First is, it is fast in operation. Second, high resolution. If you go for more number of bits, definitely you will get high resolution and high accuracy. Less expensive, as we are having less number of components here. Okay, that is also one of the advantages, less components. Here we are going to use only one comparator, one resistor, control gate and a D2A converter. So those are the components. So again, fixed conversion time. So what is the whatever the clock pulse is given, that will be the fixed time based on which the conversion rate will be fixed, and again number of bits are also fixed. So these are few advantages of successive approximation ADC. Again here pin diagram of IC is given, which is AD574, which is a 12 bit ADC. So you can see here again there is a control where clocked pulse is present, again successive approximation resistor is also present, one comparator is given here, and this circuit is of a DAC. So this is a DAC, again SAR is connected with DAC, which is a 12 channel input, as we are having this as a 12 bit ADC here. Okay, and so again this is the output side we can see here. So there is a 3 stage output buffer is present and 3 nibbles are present, nibble A, nibble B and nibble C. Nibble is nothing but it is a 4 bit combination of 4 bits is called as a nibble. Okay, so 3 nibbles will be 3 means 4 into 3, that is total 12 bits are there. So this is bit number 11, which is most significant bit, and this is bit number 0, which is least significant bit. So 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, and 11. So 0 to 11 is total 12 bits are there. So 12 bit digital data will be available. And here, this is the input side. We are going to supply input signal from this side. So total 28 pin. A to D converter, which is a successive approximation A to D converter. Commercial example we are taking here. Okay, so this was regarding successive approximation analog to digital converters. So basically we are going through each type one by one in each video. So we have already gone through flash, which is very quick. So it is again flash is again fast in operation when compared to successive approximation. Flash will be giving more quick results than successive approximation, but for higher resolution we need to go for more number of components in flash, which is again a complex design and tedious for manufacturing. And successive approximation is having less components, so it is less expensive, fixed conversion time. We can go for high resolution, high accuracy, and again operations will be fast. So this was regarding successive approximation ADCs. Thank you.